Hello guys, welcome to another episode of Bangkok Chili Peppers TV. I am Moda and today I will show you the little and nice city of Schaffhausen located in Switzerland. Let's go! In this episode I will suggest you 21 things to experience around Schaffhausen in Switzerland. I will explore this beautiful little town, visit the famous Rhine Falls and Stein am Rhein with its gorgeous buildings listed as Swiss Heritage Sites. So be ready and let's go! The city center is very small and all the main attractions are located here. Schaffhausen is the capital of the northernmost canton of Switzerland that has the same name. Canton Schaffhausen lies almost entirely on the right bank of the Rhine, with only part of Stein am Rhein on the left bank. The origins of Schaffhausen date back to around 1000 and the town quickly became a cargo depot. The river freight to Lake Constance was interrupted here due to the powerful rapids of the Rhine Falls. Schaffhausen was a city-state in the Middle Ages and became a full member of the Old Swiss Confederation in 1501. Even if the US military accidentally dropped 400 bombs on the city on April 1, 1944, Schaffhausen is still one of the best-preserved cities in Switzerland since the Middle Ages. Frongvagplatz is the main square of the town. In the Middle Ages, there was a big market here. In this square is located the Lenzquenet fountain that symbolizes the defensible city of Schaffhausen. The Frongvag Tower features an astronomical clock by Joachim Averrecht, dated 1564. Designed as show of wealth, the buildings in the old town are adorned with oriel windows, decorative window trim, and richly painted facades. Explore all the little streets around Frongvagplatz. There are numerous shops, cafes and restaurants. There are several fountains throughout the city, each of them dedicated to a different historical figure or an event that happened in the past.
There is fresh water everywhere. Oh, I love it.
In the old town there is the St. Johann Evangelical Church. Its construction began around 1000. At the end of the 14th century, a new Gothic church with three naves was built. The basement of the church contains the well-preserved remains of the previous Romanesque churches. One day after the introduction of the Reformation in 1529, the paintings and the altars were destroyed. Close to the St. Johann Church is located the Kloster Allerheiligen, All Saints Abbey, a former Benedictine monastery. Inside there are museums and also an interesting herb garden. The church, Münsterkirche, is the oldest building in Schaffhausen.
The Münsterkirche is definitely a must-see.
The Münster was first built in 1064 as the Romanesque Basilica of the Kloster Allerheiligen, then owned by the Benedictines. During the Swiss Reformation, the abbey was abolished and the Münster became the second main church in the town in 1524. This complex includes also the Museum zu Allerheiligen, an art museum, and a natural history museum, today unfortunately closed. In the old town, don't miss the Haus zum Ritter that dates early 14th century. Its paintings are considered the most important Renaissance frescoes north of the Alps. Herrenacker is the biggest square in the town, here there is the casino. Let's move forward and enjoy the view from the Moonot Fortress. You need to walk a few steps.
Let's go on top. Wow, from here the view is absolutely amazing.
The Moonot is a circular 16th century fortification in the center of Schaffhausen. It is surrounded by a small vineyard and a moat, which instead of being filled with water is now home to a family of fallow deer. The current complex was built between 1564 and 1589 under the direction of the city master builder Henry Schwarz. This is one example of transition from a castle to a modern fortress. It costed the equivalent of 800 townhouses. Visit the fortress inside is really a nice experience. Here there is a small rose garden with around 170 different species.
And now let's move forward.
If you have time, enjoy a cruise to Stein am Rhein or even Constance Lake. With a short walk I will now reach the Promenadenpark and the Church of Santa Maria. Built between 1883 and 1885, it was the first Roman Catholic church to be rebuilt in Schaffhausen after the Reformation.
Day one is over, I will now relax and drink something. In the next day I will show you the Rhine Falls and Stein am Rhein.
And now I will show you the Rheinfall that you can easily reach by public transport or bicycle.
From the train station I will take the S9 line, it takes less than 10 minutes to reach the waterfalls.
The Rheinfall are the most extended waterfalls in Europe, but let me tell you more about this place.
The Rhine Falls, in German Rheinfall, are located in Neuhausen am Rheinfall, near Schaffhausen. They are 150 meters wide and 23 meters high, the largest in Europe by average flow rate. If you like, you can take a boat to the rock island and experience the falls from the viewing platform at the top. The best time to visit the falls is from May to June because of the high amount of water. The 1st of August is the Swiss national holiday. To celebrate it, a spectacular fireworks show takes place every year on July 31st night at the Rheinfall. The Schloss Laufen is a castle that dates to the year 858. It was the home of the barons of Laufen. The castle now serves as tourist attraction and contains a restaurant and a youth hostel. The Wirth Castle dates to the 13th century. It was used as a custom house for ships traveling to the Rheinfall area. Today is a fine dining restaurant.
This is a very beautiful sight. Now we'll move forward to reach the beautiful medieval city of Stein am Rhein.
I decided to take the trains that in less than 40 minutes will bring me to Stein am Rhein. Here it's where Lake Constance spills into the River Rhine. I strongly recommend to visit this place.
I just reached Stein am Rhein and I am in the Rathausplatz, but let me tell you more about this little city.
Stein am Rhein is one of the best preserved medieval towns in Europe, despite the accidental Allies bombing on February 22, 1945 during the Second World War. The bombing destroyed 6 houses and damaged 28 buildings, some of them severely. 6 buildings in the historic old town, including the beautiful town hall, are still listed as Swiss Heritage Sites. This beautiful town gate is the Untertor, first mentioned in 1367. The original was destroyed in the bombing of 1945, the actual was rebuilt true to the original. The riverfront is a nice place to walk next to the water, with benches to sit and relax. The Rhine Bridge connects the two parts of the town. In Roman times there was a stone bridge, the current one was built between 1971 and 1974. The Villa Church, in German Stadtkirche, located behind St. George's Abbey, is well visible from almost everywhere. It dates from the 12th century and was converted into a Protestant church in the 16th century. In front of the Villa Church there is the St. George's Abbey and its museum. The first version of this Benedictine abbey dates to the 11th century. I suggest you to take the abbey tour and admire the beautiful fresco paintings. The abbey's courtyard has a door that opens right into the Rhine, offering a great view.
After a visit to the city center, I'm walking to reach the Hohenkillingen Castle. Oh, it's hot here. I am burning. The view is getting very beautiful.
Hohenkillingen Medieval Castle is located on top of a hill and dates back to the 11th century. Its last renovation was in 2008. Today Hohenkillingen is a restaurant that offers a special location for a romantic dinner. I'm curious to see the castle from inside and the view from the restaurant. Eating in a medieval castle should be really cool.
That's an interesting place that offers a very nice view.
Now it's time to go back in the town.
I am back to the Rathausplatz.
Rathausplatz is the main square in the town. The city hall, Rathaus in German, was first erected between 1539 and 1542. Its paintings by Carl von Eberlin depicts the history of Stein am Rhein. On the left of the Rathausplatz there is the oldest preserved Renaissance mural in Switzerland. The paintings by Thomas Schmid date 1520 and represent scenes from Boccaccio's Decameron and Bocca della Verità. It's time to eat something. Rotenoxen is one of the historical buildings in Rathausplatz. Inside there is a restaurant, Weinstube zum Rotenoxen. I will take half a liter of Falkenbier and a typical dish called Fleischkäse, made mainly with beef, pork and bacon.
It includes also fried eggs and salad.
Let's try it.
It tastes good.
The food and service was very good, strongly recommended. So guys, I would suggest you to spend at least a couple of days to visit Schaffhausen and Stein am Rhein. Unfortunately, this episode is over. I hope that you enjoyed. See you soon. Bye.